In this video, I will explain how the match filter is calculated in the frequency domain. Therefore, I reordered my last sketch a little bit. And on the left side are the sampled values, and on the right side is the template. Both signals go then as input to the match filter. This is only an example signal. This is not the real signal I use as template. First, we transform the template to the frequency domain by using the FFT algorithm. This is now our frequency spectrum of the template signal. And this will only be calculated once when the software starts, because the signal is always the same. We have also to transform the received signal. And this here is now the frequency spectrum of the received signal. After transforming, we conjugate the signal and get now this result. After conjugation, we multiply both spectrums. Then we calculate the inverse FFT of the multiplied array, and voila, we get our correlation array. Here is now the overview of the whole process. Now let's take a look how these values are represented in my firmware. When you start the firmware, you see the calculation of the frequency template, this right part here. This is the signal the sender sends. This is the signal we expect to receive. And this is the expanded signal. And this is the imaginary part of the signal. We filled it here with zero. And this reference signal we put then in an FFT and get out this frequency spectrum of the expected signal. I also calculated here the amplitude spectrum of the reference signal. And I don't need this in a calculation, but I can now compare it to the frequency spectrum that the oscilloscope shows me. And you see that we have here some zeros in, or that the signal goes down to zero. And we have here in this amplitude spectrum the same behavior that we have here, zeros. I want to show you one more. Do you see this peak? This does not come from our signal. It's the wrong direction. We have a lot of peaks here. And you will see this will get greater if I go with a coil over here. This peaks comes from the DC converter of the PCB 1.3. And therefore, you should not only put the coil away from the motor, you should also put the coil away from the DC-DC converter. Let's see the time signal. You see this here. This ripples comes from the DC-DC converter. I will now put the DC-DC converter a little bit I will now put the coil away from the DC-DC converter. And you see the signal is now a little bit smoother. If I bring the coil to the DC-DC converter, you see this ripples. Now let's see how the other part of the calculation is represented in the firmware. I have here a command which I named perimeter.fftl for the left coil, and I have to execute this, and then we see the calculation of the matched filter of the left coil. Now I stop this. Let's go a little bit up. And we start here with the ADC sample signal corrected by the offset. And for the FFT, we need also this imaginary part, which is filled by zero. And this both arrays we put in the FFT, and then we get out the calculated spectrum. Then we have to conjugate this spectrum, and the conjugation is done by only changing the imaginary part, and there only the sign of the numbers is changed. If you take a look here, we have here 257, and the conjugated part is minus 257. Here we have a 2 and here have a minus 2. Therefore, you only see here the imaginary part of the conjugated array. Then we have here the multiplicated result, and then here the result of the inverse fast Fourier transformation. Here you can see we don't need the imaginary part, we only need the real part of the array. And here you can see the magnitude. It's now minus 175. Okay, that is how the calculation is represented, how I can control it in the software, how it works correctly. And here it starts again with an ADC minus offset values. The next step is I want to show you this correlation area signal as a plot. To start the plot, I have to send the command perimeter.corrl to the firmware, which then starts the output of the calculated correlation array of the left coil. Here you see the peaks of the match filter, and the amplitude is negative. And when I rotate the coil by 180 degrees, then you see the amplitude is positive. In the next video, I will show you which parameter I use to determine if the signal is valid or not.